this world would I do if I ever lost you? How would I ever sleep? What good is counting sheep when memories come creeping through? I'd be continuously blue.
Come on, Nanny. Please, Nanny. Come on, Mama. Come on, Nanny. Please, Mama. Come on now. Mama, please. Mama, please. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on, Nanny. Come on, Nanny. That's right, Nanny. Come on. Come on, Nanny. That's right. Come on. Please, Mama, come on. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Hey! You want these nice glasses, huh? Better get them out of that crib.
Well, over you, dungaree, red jacket, joint. If you please, Mom, boogie, woogie, boogie, woogie, boogie, woogie, country girl. What I mean, what I mean, Mom, boogie, woogie, country girl.
Oh, he don't know what to do with that.
Now take that music with the beat rock and roll it. Give the meat, Mom, boogie, woogie, boogie, woogie, boogie, woogie, country girl. What I mean, what I mean, Mom, boogie, woogie, country girl.
1956, Lackawanna, New York. Like all Great Lakes cities was jumping. And in the middle of it all, Rachel Crosby. Nanny, that's what we all called her. Or just plain Mama.
I want you to hit me like Sugar Ray Robinson do a white man.
That's the only place he can to get away with it. You hear me?
Now seeing what a colored person could have if they worked hard and was in the right place, Nanny rushed back to her hometown, Farmville, Virginia, in that old Buick.
Y'all having a good time?
to bring more folks up north.
What I mean, my brother, little country girl. She's up every morning by that bad five to let the gold fishes, cause it keeps you alive. I'm over, 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 country girl.
If I hit this nine, I'm gonna send some money to the NAACP. Help keep Martin King out of jail.
Hey, mother.
Wish me luck.
Luck is you getting out of Georgia alive. Miss Barbara, Miss Winston.
Nanny, one of those country folk to have a taste of the city.
Y'all, we got to get this food out here. We got some hungry people.
And they partook and they partay.
Here it comes.
Yeah. Good rocking man. Yeah. Yeah, my knees start to knocking. Yeah. My love start to rocking.
No mess up in here tonight, right?
No, Nanny, you know me.
I know you better
on
not.
Friday night, she comes down. Play the jukebox and let the hair on down.
Segregation forced those folks to make their own heaven on earth.
What I mean,
and Nanny's Friday night fish fry was the place to be.
Y'all like this new car, don't you?
Now, for most folks, this was just another Friday night.
Cherry, she can milk a cow. Don't like squares, cause daddy taught her how. Boogie, 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 country girl. What I mean, my boogie, boogie, country girl. She's up every morning by that bad five to let the boat fish it, cause it keeps you alive.
But for me, this night was special.
Boogie, boogie, country girl.
It was the night my journey with Nanny began.
Straighten this out before I get back. I'll do it for you. Bill, make sure she stay out of trouble.
Ma, come
go, let's go.
Don't like where's your daddy daughter how. Boogie woogie country girl. What I mean, my boogie woogie country girl.
Lord have mercy. Get me some hot water and all the clean towels you can find.
Boogie woogie country girl.
Ruben! Yes, right now. Ruben! Where's that hot water boy?
I'm going right now,
my baby. Come, it's me and you now. Boogie okay?
Woogie country girl. Well, you did
come on, you can
mean.
Do it. You
boogie
can
woogie
do
country
it.
Girl. Yeah, swing it, man.
Yes, Lord have mercy.
Good rocking man. Yeah, my knees start to knocking.
Come on.
Yes. Hey, my boogie, 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 boogie,
thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
That wouldn't be the last time Nanny came to my rescue. By the time I was two, Aileen and my dad had split.
Clean sheets.
She figured she'd make a pit stop in Nanny's rooming house till she got back on her feet.
Here you go, Einstein.
Why must we equate intelligence with white men? What of W.E.B. Du Bois? Elaine Locke? Alexander Dumas?
Next you'll tell me Jesus was a Negro.
Jesus! Mohammed! Dinah Shore!
Clean sheets. Clean sheets.
Where's she at?
At the Flame. You know she's the barmaid there.
Well, run over there. Tell her to baby with me. Tell her I want to see her when she get off work.
Yes, ma'am.
Hey, I'm headed over to Max's, so don't wait up for me.
Have I ever?
What you doing to look curly at the Nebraska anyway?
He's spending the night with us. Want some sherbet, baby?
Don't put in my bed. He's gonna keep me up all night tossing and turning.
Well, you ain't gonna be in it.
Bill was Nanny's husband. A big old yellow Geechee boy, 17 years her junior.
I'll see y'all.
We gonna have us a little orange sherbet. We gonna have. Show me how what you do. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Let me see if I can do that.
Sleeping gifts, I ain't gonna bother.
That makes sense.
Nanny, we need to talk.
Yes, we do.
Just cause you let me stay here don't give you no right to go in my room and take my baby.
Aileen, ain't nobody took nothing from you. You can't leave that child in the room by himself. That ain't right.
And it ain't right that you go invade my privacy.
Well, I'll invade Russia when a baby is concerned. Now you ought to let his father keep him when you're working.
Nanny, I can take care of my baby. I'm working my ass off, got two jobs, and I'm doing the best I can. I'm just down the street at the Flame, and I'm running back and forth, checking on him every chance I get. He's asleep, Nanny.
What if the child wake up? He'll be scared to
death. Nanny.
Look, because you and Reuben can't make it, don't mean the child got to suffer. Let me keep him when you go to work. That way you ain't got to worry about him, and now I ain't got to worry about him. Plus, he'll get a nice hot meal.
Nanny, I feed my baby.
You ain't got to worry about him. And I ain't got to worry about him. It ain't no trouble at all.
Ricky, come up in the Flame. Is she putting my business in the street? I know I'm a good mother.
We ain't worried about what nobody else say. This here is between you and me. Let me help you with this child till you're able to help yourself.
Mm-hmm.
help sometime.
I say, hey, Mr. Conductor. Oh, let me ride. Oh, let your poor boy ride. He said, you got your ticket.
Annie, I appreciate you trying to... This my baby. And I always... Nanny, I love this. I take care.
Listen at me good now. We both want what's best for this child. I know how much you love Junior, but I also know you up against a lot right now. I'm gonna always be here for you and this baby. You understand? Now we're gonna try this. See how it work out.
And things did work out for a while.
That girl done gone and got herself locked up again.
Aileen, how come she?
Hi, Daddy. Hi, Ruben, Daddy.
Breaking into some clothing store, the policeman took them all downtown. I went down there and made bail for her.
Where is Junior?
He's upstairs getting his baseball.
But what she said to you, man?
I didn't stay. I was too upset at her.
How can she do something like this?
Listen,
look,
Ruben,
I want my son.
Look.
No, how come she no give to me my son?
That's his mother.
You his mother. You.
Listen, go on to the baseball game. Try to have a good time and forget about this mess for now.
This isn't all right.
I'm gonna talk to her later. She gonna be by here. Okay?
Hey, Junior. We don't do the game, huh? You want to catch a ball?
Better look out now. Better not be out here smoking that stuff.
Go on now, Bill. Your seat getting cold up with the flame by now.
Aileen,
Girl, Nanny up there waiting on you.
Ricky, do me a favor and go pull her to the side and tell her I'm out here. What you tell Junior?
Nothing. I'm gonna let you tell him. This is the second time I done had to come down there and get you out of jail. I don't know what you be thinking sometime, Aileen.
Just trying to provide for my child. Can't do that if I ain't got nothing.
That boy been bouncing around since he was 2 years old.
That's just the path I've been on, Nanny. And wherever I'm going, my baby's going too.
Now what sense that make? You in a stew, so he got to be in a stew?
Nanny! I won! Nanny, I won! I won! I won! Ma, I won!
You did? Well, that's my baby. Now, you go on back in the house, and we'll be in soon.
Nanny, you gonna play again?
Go on, baby. Do like your mama.
Are we gonna play one more game? Mira quien está aquí. Why you have to go and steal, Eileen?
Ruben, don't start with me.
What is wrong with your head? You are the one who's supposed to be this boy's mother,
I
and you act more
to
like
tell
a child yourself. I'm gonna tell you something,
go in
Eileen.
The house,
I want my son. You're not gonna be with him no more.
You go back in the house.
Ma?
You go get
I
your
Ruben,
things.
Take
Junior
no, 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 no. I'm not gonna let you
take this
away from
him
no more.
Stop
come on, Eileen.
Don't you touch.
Man, you better not touch her.
And you just better get right back in your car.
Nanny, I wanna live here with you.
Just go on. We'll work it out.
No! For real, Nanny, I just want to live here with you.
It'll be all right, baby. We'll talk about it. Reuben, son, leave us a minute.
Okay, Ma. Come on, Junior. Come on.
Nanny, you don't know what I'm going through.
You're right about that. But I know this. It's hard on little black boys out there. Now, that boy is something special. And whatever he want to be, I'm going to see that he get that chance.
I can do that for him, Nanny. I just wish everybody would back up off me and quit trying to run my life. I'm grown.
Girl, hush. I done heard enough and I done weighed in. Now, I'm going to take Junior and park him right here until he finish school or until you or his daddy can prove to me that you can take care of him better than I can. We got an understanding.
Nanny, I
can't. It ain't about you no more.
When I get myself together, and I am, you're gonna have to let him go because I'm coming to get my baby.
Fair enough.
Shit. But I'm gonna be right there, Nanny. I ain't going nowhere. And I'm gonna come pick him up every weekend, and I'm gonna help you with his clothes and stuff, and And I'm gonna drop you off some money every week.
Do what you can.
I'll get myself on my feet by the summer. Then I'll come get him.
I pray for you every day, Aileen. And I know you can do whatever you put your mind to. And despite all this other mess, I'm proud of you for doing the right thing about this child.
Need this life I'm living right now. You don't need it.
My mom did come see me every weekend for a while. Then I didn't see her for a long time. Nanny told me she had to go away. Then one Christmas, I got a big box. Nanny said, look what your mama sent you. It was 20 years later that I found out Nanny had given it to me. People used to say, 32 Watson Avenue ain't no place to raise a child. All them fools Nanny done taken in. Cause see, all of Nanny's roomers were ramblers or drifters of some sort. And they each had some experience with prison, mental hospital, alcohol, drugs, pimping, gambling, or church. And every one of them had a story to tell.
Ruben, when I was playing ball with the Negro League, we used to travel all over.
There was old Poe Carl, raconteur and king of the malaprops.
New York City, now that's a city. That's a city where they got the Statue of Liberty. Well, the French give it to them, delivered her, put her right there in the harbor.
Jeff, come on now.
I thought Ricky was the coolest dude living there. And she was. Shaky Winfield and Numbfinger Pete.
Nas the longest.
Damn, told you you're ignorant.
Shaky was Nanny's second cousin. Nanny brought his whole family up from Virginia.
That's a big river.
Numbfinger Pete thought he was smarter than everybody else and was quick to bring up the point.
I spent more than a year or two with Luke College.
Oh, yeah? Well, what they teach you, huh? How to be an ass?
Pete got drunk and fell out in the snow.
You ain't got no education.
His fingers were frostbitten so bad they had to remove all of them, except his forefinger and thumb.
Clean sheets.
Jimmy Lee and Pauline. One day they tried to cut each other's throats. The next day.
Hey, Doc.
That's Freddie Cobb. He was the first person I ever saw sign his name with an X. And Mr. Paul. Uncle Bill told me he had killed somebody.
Doctor told me to quit drinking. Said I had roaches of the liver. I didn't know whether to believe him or not. But I did feel something kind of moving around in there.
That's Lonnie. Although he didn't live at 32 Watson, he was always standing around outside jangling his keys.
Lonnie, baby.
Nanny used to say,
come on, let's go inside.
All of them went to Vietnam.
I got some cornbread, nice hot corn.
But only half of them came back.
That's an E7 chord. One of the first things you learn about the blues. Like John Lee Hooker say, you don't need to play but one chord. See, this is our story. This ain't in no history book.
Mr. Lucius?
Mm-hmm. And just like me, they all had a story as to how they ended up at Nanny's.
How did you lose your arm? I was just wondering.
I was courting this gal named Annie Mae for more than a year. And I fully intended to marry that gal. And one day she told me about this old white boy named Joe Tinslet, who'd been picking with her. And saying things like, well, you're my little brown sugar. Now, one day, my uncle, keeping this straw hat he brung back from Cincinnati, because he know I love me some hats, I put that hat on, shined my shoes, got my gal, and we strut to church. And on the way back home, up come Joe Tinsley with his awesome buggy. And he says something. And I act like I don't hear him. So he stepped down and he slapped my hat off my head.
He slapped you?
Mm-hmm.
You hit him back?
Annie Mae was holding onto my arm, whispering, it's okay, Lucius, it's okay. And Joe Tinsley climbed back up on his perch and said, you girls, have a nice day. And when I dropped Annie Mae off, I just kept right on walking, picking up a tree branch along the way. He was sitting on the porch, drinking a jar of lemonade. But he saw me stepping up to him. Open his mouth up to speak. And I slapped him upside his head with that piece of lumber.
just like you would a hog. When his body hit the ground, it seemed like he wanted to get back up, but I hit him again and again. And then I just walked away. I didn't run, Junior. I walked. And I took and put some turpentine in my shoes so the dogs couldn't follow me. And I took off of the swamp. I didn't sleep for 2 days. I was so tired. And I dozed off finally. And I woke up to this sharp pinch in my arm. And then I see this snake squirm off. So I pulled out my case knife. I tried to open up the spot so the venom could ease out with the blood, the pus. But it started to swelling and bleeding. So I stuck it in there again until I hit bone. I packed it with mud and leaves, and I kept on going. Through the grace of God, I got out of that swamp. Got to Augusta, Georgia, where this color doctor told me I was lucky to be alive. But he had to take that arm. Yeah. When I come up north, that's when I first heard about Miss Rachel. She had given so many people a start. When we met, she asked me, what happened to your arm? I say, I was defending this lady's honor. And she say, but I'm just gonna tell you right now, just in case you ever wonder, I can handle my own honor. So your other arm is safe.
Now when folks got north, Nanny would find them jobs. And if they didn't have nothing, she provided food, shelter, clothing. Nanny was like the government, if it really worked. And she didn't just wait for folks to come to her.
Mr. Taylor? Mr. Taylor?
Ray, how you doing?
I'm fine. Thank you, Mr. Taylor. How you doing?
Oh, just fair to middling, man. Just fair to middling.
This here my son, Reuben.
He was a tall man with a barrel chest and one leg.
Oh, boy. But you smart, too, huh? What's the matter? You ain't never seen a one-legged man before?
And with that tongue darting in out of his mouth, he looked like a giant Negro iguana.
Huh? And watch this. Now, what you gonna stand there and watch a one-legged man throw a rock further than you? Try it. Yeah!
Now, I don't allow no wild women in and out of my place.
I don't do no cavorting, no gallivanting with none of these wild and crazy women out here.
And your rent is due on time. $25 a week, room and board.
And when my rent come, you know, I pay you in advance. In fact, I got me $106 saved up. You can have any part of that, ma'am.
No, Mr. Taylor, you keep your money. And you got to take your medication.
You ain't got no problem, daughter. Me, I don't bother nobody. I stay to myself. And I take my medicine just the way you see on the bottle. Now, Miss Ray, as long as I know you, you've been like a rock to all the people that come to you in need. Mother, I'm in need. I'm just asking for a chance.
And that's how we all ended up at Nanny's. Now, there wasn't a person dead or alive who hadn't asked Nanny,
what are you doing with Bill?
But Nanny told me, sometimes a man and a woman have an understanding that no one else understands. Not even their own selves.
Put on your red dress, baby. 'Cause we
think some fool might wanna
buy. Oh, no, that's awful.
Y'all see them Negroes walking around shouting Black Power?
Black Panthers?
Mm-hmm. Hair as nappy as can be. I need to get them up in my chair. I got all the Black Power they need right in this hot corner.
Now, I kind of like the hair all natural like that. I might get me one.
What?
What's wrong with that?
You don't like to use this.
Nah, too heavy. Make me feel trapped.
Sandwich, baby. Now, when we go out tonight, Mr. Paul's gonna be here in case you need anything.
Okay, Mom.
You all right, Mr. Taylor?
Yes, ma'am.
Pauline, I'm sorry. He gonna have me going to the body all burnt up around the forehead. Well, you can't be fidgeting like that.
Paul, you don't scream like that when Jimmy Lee be going upside her head.
And you know she'll be right up at Maxie's with him tonight.
Uh-uh, I'm going with Nanny. Yes, indeed. The lady's gonna show out tonight.
Bertha, you know you're always welcome to come along with us.
Let me take with Java, because you know how I loves my piece of man.
Maybe we ought to take all these piece of men we got together, make one whole man, spread him around.
I know that's right, Nanny.
See, y'all over there laughing, but Ray knows she ain't going nowhere without me. She gonna sit right there till I say, come on.
Did you hear that?
I see his lips flapping, and I don't feel nothing but a breeze.
Okay, well, if that's the case, then maybe I'll go out and get myself a new girlfriend then.
Oh. And when y'all through, why don't you bring her back here so she can help me do some of this work around here?
The 40s dance was the event of the year. Everybody would show out to party and reminisce about its heyday. When Billy Eckstein, Billie Holiday, Lionel Hampton, and Hot Lips Page would perform, they would laugh about that night that Wynonna Harris got drunk and fell off the bar stool, or talk about that day that Malcolm X stood out in front, admonishing the liquor and gambling that was always flowing inside. And it didn't matter how you were dressed from the ankle up, because it was the shoe that made you sharp.
Walking with my baby, she got great big feet. She long, lean, and legged, ain't had nothing to eat. But she's my baby, and I love her just the same. Crazy about that woman, cause Caldonia is her name. Yellow, yeah! Yellow, yeah!
And they were dining on Maxie's famous fish sandwich with the special sauce and wilted lettuce.
They cooked the lettuce on these sandwiches. When they put the cold lettuce on the hot fish, it's cooked.
No, the sauce is hot. And when they put that on there, it wilts the lettuce.
And they were all there. Sucking Finger Willie, Buffalo Shorty, Boat Jack, Big Will, Pepper Red, and Dick Barrymore.
You know, my mama told me leave Caldonia alone. That's what she told me. She said, son, leave that woman alone. She ain't no good. Don't bother her.
Nanny, you in?
But mama didn't know what Caldonia was putting down.
I think I'm gonna let mine ride on Dick Barrymore.
I'm going by Caldonia's house. I ask her just one more time.
Gentlemen.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen.
While they were at Maxie's listening to Jump Blues, the blues I was hearing had a whole different kind of sound.
There were a lot of things happening in 1956.
That's the year I was born.
You know who that is?
No.
That's Nat King Cole, one of the world's greatest song stylists. That's the night that he performed in front of an all-white audience and a mob attacked him. You see, he was black. Black and shiny, and his hair was always perfect, and not a strand out of place. And those white folks jumped on that stage that night, and old Nat King Cole jumped the hell off. His hair was messed up that night. Talk about getting your kicks on Route 66. He got his kicks the hell out of there that night.
When you think Jimmy Lee and Bill gonna get here?
Child, I ain't studying Bill.
Tell him, Nanny, ain't gotta wait for no man.
Brother, let's say we are.
Come on,
brother.
Come on, Pauline.
Quarter boy, down the gas. Baby, I sure do hope it lasts. Destination love. Destination love. If I get stuck, give me a shove. Destination.
Brought you winning.
So how you been?
Oh, Miss Rachel. I'm still vertical. Now, I know you're gonna let me have one dance, but my bunions started hurting in these Stetsons. Damn, Bill. Girl, you and me, we go all the way back to Palmville, Virginia.
That same year, they enforced the Supreme Court decision on mandatory desegregation. Everything's equal. Go anywhere you want to. My brother thought that. And he got into a scuffle with a white fella. He ended up breaking the guy's arm. And they took him to jail and to court. The judge says, second time you heard a white guy this year. My brother says, I don't understand, Your Honor. What do you mean? Says, the first time you heard a white man, you told him to go to hell. You hurt his feelings. Now you're breaking this guy's arm. Two white men you hurt in 1 year. It's 10 years. You understand what I'm saying to you? You can't go around hurting white folks in any form or fashion, even if you're white. Yeah, it's John Brown. That's history, son. You look it up.
You better do it, Jakey.
Played the Yankees in the World Series. A lot of people say I sound like Jack Robinson. Well, I always admired him because he sounded what? American. I spent 10 years in jail learning how to sound American.
Well, I crossed the bridge and climbed the hill. It only seemed up twice. If this soul car goes one more mile, I'll be in paradise. She'll be waiting.
Taylor, have a drink with us.
Well, I gotta go back, finish taking these fools' money, but I'll be back to wet my whistle in a bit. Dolphin's still good.
You know it is.
Hey, Lackawanna. Are you having fun tonight? Well, all right.
Those two about to work my last nerve.
You be a polite gentleman, or what the hell are you doing?
Ricky do look good in that suit.
Welcome to the stage, Mr. Otis McClanahan.
Thank you.
1956 was, it was just one of those years. I was in.
My baby's gone.
Oh, hell with it. I wrote a poem about it that can probably tell it better than I can.
I wake up early in the morning in my bedroom all alone.
Oh, I love that woman. When I'm with her, I felt like a king. When I'm with that woman, I didn't need a doggone thing. Oh, Lord. I went down that woman's house and knock on her door. The nerve to tell me she didn't want me no more. Oh Lord.
I said, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy on me. Lord, on me. Lord, have mercy. Yeah. Lord, have mercy.
Strangest feeling she was with another man. I had the strangest feeling she was with another man.
I kicked down that woman's door. She was naked, holding that man, making love on the floor. I lost my mind for a time, oh Lord. I grabbed that butcher knife. He jumped up in my face and I swung. I swung that butcher knife. I dug it into his body. I pulled it out. I dug it in. I pulled it out. Oh, oh Lord. There was blood. Blood on my hands, and there was blood. Blood on my face, blood on the walls, blood all over the place. When I had finished swinging that knife, I had taken his and her life.
Something inside me, Lord. Just won't let me.
I heard them fools cut each other's throats. I got drunk and fell asleep at my sister Louise's house. I'm gonna give me a couple hours sleep, and me and Doc, we going fishing in the morning.
You can't hurt me no more, Bill.
But I can't go to my sister's house.
I was looking for you to show up at Maxie's tonight.
You the one told me you ain't need me for nothing.
Oh, well, that's a good thing. Because, see, when I do need you, for me, Bill, you ain't nowhere to be found.
Woman, what you talking about?
But you can't hurt me no more. I'm numb. You know, sometimes I look at you, don't even see you. You touch me, and I don't feel you. But I can smell you. And I know I'm alive. That stench ain't just some other woman's cheap perfume. It's your soul, Bill. Your rotten soul.
To you.
I had an accident.
What happened to her?
Morning.
Morning.
Doc, look what I got you.
Wow, a new fishing pole.
That ain't just no fishing pole, that's a Zebco. Well, come on, if you're going, they're gonna be done cut off the fish if we don't get there soon.
Take your sweater.
Let's go. Boy, we're gonna have ourselves a day.
Hello. Oh, Nanny, it's Junior. Collect.
Collect? Hello? Where you at? Where Bill? Say what? What happened?
What you mean?
You left here to go fishing with Bill, and you come back here shivering to death. I want to know what happened.
Well, Uncle Bill and I left, and he had to make a stop.
Come on in, sweetheart. What kind of stop?
Just a stop.
Then what?
Duke and I decided to go swimming.
Here I come, Duke!
Where was Bill?
Huh?
Where was Bill?
Busy.
Then what?
We finished swimming and...
Doc, what we got? Where were your clothes?
I tell him I can't find them.
What do you mean you can't find?
And then he starts yelling.
Where the reel? Well, that's $200 worth of good fishing gear. You didn't watch them. What else you had to do?
He just kept on yelling.
Bill, don't talk to that child like that.
Shut up, woman. You don't know nothing about this. You find them reels and you call me, or you find another way home.
So you just can't leave this child?
I will leave you. Some of that superwoman.
If you ever mistreat this child again, man, I will blow the back of your head off.
You ain't the only one got a gun.
I ain't gonna say it no more.
I don't care. You say as many times you want to. You gonna pull out that old gun of yours if you want, but I tell you, you best be ready to use it.
I know the rules, Bill.
Oh, I'm supposed to be scared now? That what I'm supposed to be? I ain't no play toy. Going bear hunting with a toothpick and messing around with me, huh? Blow the back of my head off. Shit.
Be Uncle Bill's friend no more.
Uncle Bill love you. He just act a fool sometime. Hey, Bill know he did something silly and hurt you.
Nanny, I'm mad, so you should be mad too.
Child, I done had my share kicking ass, kicking down doors, breaking out windows, and acting a fool. But that didn't suit me. I'm a lady. And I'm gonna conduct myself as such.
But I ain't no lady. And when Uncle Bill hurts you, I wanna hurt him back. Sometimes I hate him.
I don't ever wanna hear that word out of you. You hear me? I done had to deal with that poison my whole life. It's all right to be upset, but not hate. Now, I know you're just trying to help Nanny, and I thank you. But I've been taking care of myself for 50-some-odd years just fine and ain't had to hate nor hurt nobody to do it. Now, you know Uncle Bill love you, right?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. You gonna give him another chance? I'll tell you something. If he do something else, I'll hold him down and you slap him.
After you blow the back of his head off?
Oh, Lord. You go to sleep, boy. Night.
Night, Nanny. Night.
Things between Nanny and Bill were calm after that. But everything came to a head the day the social worker showed up.
Dude.
Go ahead with it.
I was in World War II when your black ass was still in Alabama picking cotton. Fought for my country, stood on the front line with bullets whizzing by my head. Don't tell me shit. Come here, Doc. Read it. Tell him what it said right there.
United States Army, 1946. Corporal Fred J. Cobbs, honorable discharge.
Shit. Did you hear him? Did you hear him ask?
Yeah, Fred. That piece of paper don't mean a damn thing. You still wasn't nothing honorable. Damn that you had no gun.
Knowed my job. And I did my job. Stacking bodies. I was stacking them one on top of the other. It's like you would a 50-pound sack of potato.
Freddie, I got some people here.
Just getting them so I could take them somewhere and bury them with some kind of dignity. Something that they couldn't get over here, and I'd be damned if they won't gonna get it over there. I'm a man!
Freddie.
And I bury men, and I watch them standing right there grinning. No, they ain't give me no gun to shoot at them, but that ain't stopped them from shooting at me. So don't you.
What on earth is going on?
How far did you go in school, Mrs. Crosby?
Well,
I had to start working after my mama passed, so I went to third grade, but Bill here, he went all the way to sixth grade. I've been looking after children my whole life, whether family or somebody else's. Junior is closer to me than my own family.
Reuben, do you mind if we ask you a few questions?
If you want to.
You have excellent grades.
Thank you.
Excuse me, would you like something to drink?
No, we're fine, thanks. Do you like living here, Reuben?
I love being with Nanny.
But are you happy here?
Shh, quiet.
Mrs. Carmichael asked you a question, Reuben.
I have a lot of fun here. Everybody is my friend. They teach me stuff. Sometimes I teach them stuff.
Stuff? Like what?
Like how to play piccino and the harmonica and history stuff, too. Like about the Negro Leagues or like when the white people beat up Nat King Cole.
Would you like to live in a regular house?
What regular?
I know. Regular old family with a big yard and a garage and...
We have a yard and Uncle Bill has a garage.
Think you'd like to look at some of these other places?
No, thank you. I'm happy here with Nanny.
Doesn't hurt to take a look, Reuben.
All right, come on.
I beg your pardon.
Let's go.
Bill.
Let's go, I say.
Bill.
Mr. Crosby, we're just...
Get your ass out of here! Move!
I'm sorry. Bill gets a little wound up.
Bill definitely talked to you, Mrs. Crosby.
It must be crazy talking to Junior like that. Ain't taking that child nowhere.
See, that's what's wrong with your brain. They liable to come back here and snatch him up because they think you crazy.
No, that's why they ain't coming back here, because they know I am. And before I let them take... my best buddy out of here, they gonna have to take me out of here first. Cause we got some more fish to catch. Right, Doc?
I never heard any more talk about me moving away ever again. I guess it's just like Nanny said. Sometimes a man and a woman have an understanding that no one else understands. Nanny gave every drop of herself to people. Outstretched arms reaching for her, expecting Nanny to put a stop to their fall.
Who knock? Who knock, I say?
Nanny, it's Laura.
Laura, what you doing with them babies out here this time of night? Lord, come on. You're gonna catch your death. Come on.
My biggest fear was that Nanny would give all of herself away.
Let me look at you.
And there wouldn't be anything left for her.
Let me see. Come on, baby. Let me see. Lord have mercy.
Jesse keeps beating on me, Nanny. I can't take it anymore. He slapped me with the back of his hand. I'm a mess.
Here. With this ice on your mouth. Want me to take you to the hospital? Well, I can make a bed for the kids right here on the couch, and y'all can just stay right on up here with me.
He'll come looking for us tomorrow, Nanny. He knows I'll come here.
Who let me take care of that? Hmm? You just hush and keep that ice on your mouth. You babies got to get some sleep.
Nanny, what's wrong?
Get back in bed, boy.
But what's wrong, Nanny?
You hear what I say? Go on, get back in bed. Go on now.
I'm just so tired of this, Nanny. I can't. I can't.
I know. Nanny got you.
Go on. Go on, let it out.
It's gonna be all right.
That's some pretty catfish. That's a pretty catfish right there.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Junior.
Huh?
Skinning a catfish. Snapping peas. Now, these idiosyncrasies are strictly Negro customs.
Man, they... go away from here with that silly talk.
Go on way.
Go away.
I live here.
Go away.
Go on way. That isn't even a proper sentence. See, I spent more than a year.
Boogaloo at... College.
Boogaloo College, and I'm not afraid of my education. I understand the psychological workings of animosity. Shakespeare called envy.
The green-eyed monster.
Crystal's dad just...
Miss Rachel, I come for my family.
Sit down, boy. You hungry?
I don't need to sit down, Miss Rachel. Just tell Laura so to come on.
I got a fresh pot of neck bones back here, some...
Where's she at?
Wherever she at. You're gonna have to go through me to get to her. Now go on, knock me down. Go on. If that's the onliest way you know how to do things, knock Nanny down, because I can handle it.
I ain't got no beef with you, Miss Rachel. But with all due respect, you all up in between me and mine.
No, what I'm up between is right and wrong. Now, when that gal come in here in the middle of the night, half-dressed with her babies in tow, blood all over her swole-up mouth, I was there for her. And I ain't gonna turn back now. So if you wanna give me a dose of what you give her, bring it on. 'Cause if you ever touch that child again, baby, we gonna dance. She ready. She'll call you. I'll tell her you was here. You take friends with you, then make your toss and soar. You got bags on your eyes, bigger than barn or door. Wake up, party girl, don't you know the cops around. You tear on your feet, and you all your last go round.
Laura decided she didn't want to go another round with the Golden Gloves champ. So that winter, Nanny huddled them all in her Lincoln and took them to Toronto to be with Laura's mother. And of course, Nanny took me along for the ride. I was nervous the whole way thinking,
Nanny don't know how to act in front of no rich white folk.
Hey,
tea?
Yes, thank you.
Thank you for saving my daughter's life.
Anybody would have done the same.
Young man?
You got a cold Pepsi Cola? Tea. Yes, thank you.
Miss Rachel, I understand that you're the mother of the community. Always an open hand and an open heart.
Thank you. Mm.
These are delicious. And you don't skimp on the butter.
Reuben? Mmm. These cookies are delicious with lots of butter.
Come on, I'll give you my secret recipe.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a
diamond. It was almost like a fairy tale. Laura's mother treated us like royalty. It was the first time that I thought about how tired Nanny must really be. And I couldn't help but think, in a couple of hours, Nanny's gonna be right back in the middle of whiskey and piss, vomit and blood, madness and mayhem.
Give me my goddamn keys! Mine, and I won't. I ain't afraid of no Viet Cong. They're gonna give me my keys and they're gonna have to kill me.
What the hell?
Oh my God, he lost his mind!
Yo! Nanny, I'm gonna call Bill.
I'm gonna go get his sister!
Revolution is your every action. Revolution is your every action.
They're gonna give me my goddamn keys!
Damn it, boy! I'm gonna call the police!
Let me talk to him.
No, I ain't gonna leave you in here, Mama. With him.
Go! I said go!
Daddy, come on!
He's got my goddamn keys. I want my goddamn keys.
Keys, baby. Now come on, sit on down. Them beans almost ready.
You're gonna have to give me it, or I'm gonna have to kill somebody.
Sit on down, huh? Sit down now. Now hush up all that noise. Here, come on. Sit down. Eat that cornbread till them beans warm up.
Hey, baby brother.
I'm all right, baby. Bill! Bill!
Someone,
Bill! Bill! Bill!
You all right, woman?
I'm all right, Bill. I'm all right.
get hard to bear, and there is no one to hear me share. I just call on King Jesus.
Mm. You ever get afraid of death?
Death is your friend. And when this long, hard journey is over, and I'm too tired to go on, death will say, I understand. Then there'll be no more trouble, no more pain.
How long you been taking care of people, Nanny?
Since I was a child. There's always been a part of me that wanted to try to fix things. People, try to make them feel whole again.
That's why you got this rooming house?
Not exactly. That just kind of come to me. I was working out at Woodlawn for this white couple. Had two beautiful boys. On Saturday before my day off, I'd bake cakes and pies so they'd have some sweets after their Sunday dinner. The lady at the house was so impressed. She said, Rachel, you don't have to do this. You could be home. This is so nice. I said, well, I'm just looking out for my boys. Then she told me that if I was gonna make cakes, I had to make one to take home to my family. Well, one Saturday, I'll never forget it. She lit into me. Where you going with that cake? I can't afford to feed you and your whole family every week. Then she stormed off one way, and I dropped that cake on the table and stormed off the other. On my drive home, there was so much turmoil inside of me. I could still feel the warmth from the goodbye hug them boys give me. And I held on to it, because I knew that'd be the last hug they was ever gonna give me. Because from that day forward, I was gonna be my own boss. And that I was. Bought me a little place on Simon Avenue. Place had 5 bedrooms. I rented 4 of those out. Took my car, started a little shuttle. That led to a cab stand. Then I got this place here. That made 2 rooming houses, a cab stand, and a restaurant. God has truly blessed this little old gal from a tobacco farm in Virginia.
Why didn't you ever have any kids, Nanny?
Oh, I had a little girl.
You did?
Mm-hmm. With my first husband, Dick Johnson. Mm. She was my heart. Named her Lillian. But God took her early on. She wasn't no more than 3 years old. Had a bout with that pneumonia.
You never talked about her, Nanny.
No. That was the hardest thing I ever had to face in my life. You know, they say God don't make no mistakes. I know one thing. Took me a long time to get on speaking terms with God after that. But you know, then I come to realize that even though God took that one that was so special from me, he filled my life up with so many others. But most of all, most of all, he gave me you. Now get back on that job, mister. Don't want to leave them kitchens undone.
When Nanny first took me in, she made a vow to see me through school. Little did I know that going into one world would signal the end of another.
Oh,
My father went to have a simple bypass and never made it out of the recovery room. He had always been there for me. Aileen was still battling her demons. When it finally looked like she might be winning, she was gunned down in a drive-by and killed. My sophomore year, Nanny was diagnosed with breast cancer. When Death came by to visit Nanny, she told him, God ain't done with me yet, so move on down the line.
Stay on the speed limit.
The year I graduated, we found out that Uncle Bill had lung cancer. Within 6 months, he was gone.
I'ma keep on a-talkin', I ain't gonna sing no more.
Businesses all up and down Wasson Avenue started closing down. Because for every door integration opened, it meant the closing of another in the community. Maxis, The Flame, The Rim. The vibrant world of Lackawanna I'd always known started to fade away. Soon, probably start marching over here for you. Come on, come on. Get your cards here.
All right.
Coming home.
Where else was I gonna go?
Anybody check on Miss Francis lately? Richard. Oh Lord. Boy, you know who I'm talking to. Junior, come here. Stop by there and take her a plate. Pauline, Miss Magdalene, her wake tomorrow, ain't it?
Mm-hmm.
So why you out there?
Annie, you can't take care of these people. You're sick yourself.
Baby, go and do what I ask you. I'm all right. This is what I do. Go on now.
Yes, ma'am.
Ooh, Pauline, what you got over there smelling so good?
Everything. I know how you like the chicken and dumplings, mm-hmm. So I got that.
Mm-hmm.
And I fried up some porgies.
Ooh.
And I got some greens and some turnips and some mustard and some macaroni and cheese, and for dessert, your favorite.
It is.
Coconut layer cake.
It is. Girl, you done outdone yourself, baby. Yeah. I'm gonna go and check on something in the kitchen.
Mother.
Yes, baby.
Come here.
What?
Thank you, Nanny.
to take fragments and make them whole. That's what Nanny did. Piecing together, pulling together, a community. People of 32 Wasson Avenue wanted me to have more, amount more than they did. And so they gave me that bit of themselves that they felt was their best. And the blues I heard and the stories they told will live inside of me forever.